Hi.
Yeah,
where's the
yeah.
camera?
I am a titan.
Is it there?
Let
wow.
me look at my own butt.
That's
disconcerting.
No, just.
That's how you look, Jessica.
Okay, I'm fat. I'm just kidding. I'm not. I know. I'm just kidding. I'm not.
Yeah,
Brett
care.
Is, but I'm.
Thank
you're
you.
Not. I love you.
All right.
You're, okay.
Why would that? Okay, never mind.
Doesn't even matter.
All right.
So I know there's people still coming in, but I always hate like starting late, because we probably have to stop at 4.
Right, right.
So I'm Jessica Calvello. Hey, hi! Otherwise known as Typhoid Mary. I play Hanji in Attack on Titan, and I actually sound more like her today than I think I actually do in the dub. But thanks for being here, and I'm gonna pass it on off to my colleagues here.
You're next.
Bitches.
I am.
Yeah.
My name's David Matranga, and I play Bertolt Hoover in Attack on Titan.
Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Well, that's it?
Yeah, right? I mean,
okay.
I don't know, yeah, just...
I thought you were gonna do more, because she said more words than...
Yeah, she just talked about her sickness and Typhoid Mary. You guys don't want to know about my sickness. It's mental.
It's really, really big. Get it? Okay, y'all, whatever.
For science.
Well, my name is Brett Weaver, and I play Gunter in Attack on Titan. And also an Attack on Titan Jr., so that's good,
oh,
too.
Oh, yeah. Titan. But it's we like to call it Titan Babies, like Muppet Babies.
Yes.
Yeah.
You thought that was funny.
Of course, my best thing is now that we know that there's a season 2, I've been talking to Mike McFarlane going, so great, season 2, what do you... What am I gonna?
No, because you're dead.
I'm.
When Brett and I actually watched Attack on Titan when it was coming out, we didn't even know who had the dub, and we were like, that guy with the Hershey's Kiss hair. I'm like, Brett, you'd be really good at that part. I'm not even kidding. And we called him the guy. We could never remember his name, so
Hershey's
he was the
kiss
guy
head.
With the Hershey's Kiss head. Yeah.
Yeah.
Anyway, so do we just want to do like a Q&A and kind of get started, or?
I want you to tell the story of how you got Hanji.
Okay, but then you guys have to tell your stories too.
Yeah, that's
okay.
A good way to
okay,
open it.
Okay, yeah, so I like the story. It's, so, sorry, dying. I know. So Brett and I actually, because we're really good friends, we actually kind of hate each other.
Okay.
The end. Not really a story. But we really did get together on Saturday nights and we watched Attack on Titan. We were fans of the series. It was really, we really enjoyed it. We didn't know who had the dub because Brett and I don't keep up with that. We really don't. We're like, whoever has it? We're like, wow, we really would like to be in this. And I swear, and I say this at every panel, and I really want people to believe me, I zeroed in on Hanji. I really, really wanted to play that character because I thought she was... sort of light in a very dark and dismal world. It's, you know, Attack on Titan, it's a comedy, right?
dark comedy.
Your friends are dying left and right. You don't know if they're going to make it to the next episode. And I think in that kind of a show, you need some balance restored. And so I think Hanji and Sasha bringing in some comedic elements are really, really good for that. So, and I gravitate toward those comedic characters anyway, because I'm funny. Not right now, but sometimes.
You are
funny.
You're funny.
You're definitely funny.
I really am.
Sometimes it reaches a boiling point where it turns to annoying, but I mean,
okay,
I'm just
but
kidding.
At the moment, it's just, I'm good.
Oh, yeah, no,
yes,
you're
you
good.
Are, definitely.
No one's laughing, but, well, laugh. Oh, David Bowie. Did anyone get that? From Labyrinth. Well, laugh. All right, anyway, so I can't believe y'all did.
That's awesome.
Remember,
this is all perfect.
God,
they're
mother.
All
I'm not gonna
under
curse.
20.
All right.
Okay.
But I know you've seen Labyrinth. Wow. Okay. So anyway, so fast forward, because I'm talking too much. So auditions, right? I was like, oh my God, auditions! Ah! So excited to audition. And I did, and you really hope for the best when you get an audition via email. You work on them and you send them off and you're like, gosh, and you don't hear anything for weeks. And I'd heard, sorry. I'd heard that like my friends were getting cast, and I was like, Brett, have you heard anything? And he's like, nope. And I'm like, I haven't heard. I'm like, oh, I didn't get it. And I was so devastated. And then one day I get a call, and I let it go to voicemail, and it's Mike, and he's like, Jessica, give me a call back. And I'm like, oh my God. And I'm in a park. And I'm like, okay, he called me. Like, at this point, I don't even care if I'm a character that's like stuck underneath a Titan's foot. Like, I don't care. Like, if there's a janitor, I'll be the janitor. I don't think there's any janitors. But if there were, I'd be a really good janitor. Like,
janitor
I don't
titan.
Care.
Yeah.
Janitor Titan.
Janitor
somebody's
titan.
Somebody's got to clean up that mess.
Yeah. Seriously. Yeah. Right. And I was like, that will be me. So I call him, and he's like, hey, and he was, I don't know, he was like really distracted. He's like, oh, hey, Jessica, yeah, we got your audition. I'm like, I know, that's why you're calling. You. I'm like, who am I? He's like, hold on. He puts me on hold. And I'm like, you're so uncool for that. So uncool for many things, Mike. You are. There's a list. But that was really uncool. I'm just kidding. No, he really put me on hold. And then he comes back, and he's like, yeah, you're, and there's like paper shuffling, and I'm like, oh my God, who am I? And he's like, oh, you're gonna play Hanji. And I screamed so loudly. There's this woman in the park with her baby. And she picked up her baby and she was hauling it. And I felt really bad because I was like, oh, I'm so sorry to scare you, but I'm Hanji. And that did not help at all. She was like, crazy bitch. I mean, I was. She ran with her baby and I was like, your baby's cute. I'm sorry. I love science. It was really, and I just jumped around like a crazy person by myself in the park, and it was awesome. And Mike said I made his ear bleed, and I did. And man, what a freaking honor and just joy to be able to play such a wonderful character. So,
This is how it goes. I'm next up.
How did you feel when you heard that Jessica got Hanji? So.
I heard the scream as well from Houston.
You actually had that baby, and she just mistook you for a woman.
Exactly. So, I'm a nanny. In my spare time, and I happen to be. Yeah, in a dress.
I'm sorry I scared you. You look really pretty in purple polka dots.
I really, you know, like, eyeshadow and a blush works really well on me.
I actually was going to hit on you, but you ran off.
Right. So well, you screamed Hanji at me.
I know.
For science!
Science was scarier than Hanji. No, I just like that after Jessica finishes, Brett just goes... all right. Yeah, my story is, you know, I'm based in Houston, so whenever, you know, it's always better to be in person auditioning than it is via email, I think, just in general. You know, you get to have a personal interaction, you can take adjustments if the director wants you to try it a different way. And so you're usually, I would just for the most part, at a disadvantage when you're auditioning via email, although more and more that's happening. But so I, like other actors in Austin and Houston and LA and I don't know where else they went, but emailed in some auditions, and you know, you get five or six characters, lines from that character, and it's not necessarily all the characters from the show. You might be, you might read for a character and get cast as a different character, which is exactly what happened for me. Bertolt doesn't have enough lines in the first season to warrant, you know, an audition with his lines. So I auditioned for Aaron, and I put myself on tape for Rhina, I think, and Armin even. I was like, I'm gonna show them a little range here. I'll never get cast as this, but let me try. And you know, same thing. I didn't hear anything for a while. Didn't hear anything for a while, and I had known a little bit of. I had seen. I think one episode and read a little bit about it and then started talking to some of my friends about it and really slowly started to understand how big it was as far as a fan favorite and just what the story was and really after auditioning got more and more and more interested, you know? So I finally got a call from Mike, you know, which was great that he called people, but the way that it sounded when I answered the phone, he was like, hey, David, it's Mike McFarlane. I was like, hey. And he's like, and I was like, is he calling me to tell me I didn't get anything? Because usually you don't hear. If you didn't get the role, no one's gonna give you a courtesy call. Like, hey, good job, but you didn't get it. So you usually, you know, if you get something, you feel like you're gonna get it. And this is, I don't know, I'll just say what he said. He said, and we had worked together on Wolf Children prior, so we'd already had a working relationship, and I was excited to work with him again. And he said, "So, I want to offer you a role. It's he doesn't have a lot to do in the first season, but it's a really interesting role, and it really has the potential to be bigger later on."
You bet.
And I was like, cool, awesome, great, sure, I'll do it. I hadn't read ahead or anything like that, and I don't want to, you know, jump into spoilers or anything, but I didn't really get what he meant until later on, after I recorded the first season. So yeah, that's my journey to Attack on Titan.
Did you scare a baby?
And did I scare a baby?
Yeah.
I didn't scare a baby.
Then my story's better.
Scaring a baby I do like quite frequently, so it's not like an event in my world.
Right,
yeah.
Right,
every day. And I loved doing junior high. It's been a blast to do that too, so anyway.
Yeah, awesome.
He texted me.
So
you're the Hershey's Kiss person.
Yeah, you're the Hershey's. I'm like, all right. Now, I had auditioned for every old guy character. That was because I'm just, you know, accepting my fate and my age and the sound of my voice, and that, you know, I've been doing this 20 years. And so, yes, I've played 16-year-old boys before, but, you know, listen to this voice. Do you think this voice would ever work on a 16-year-old boy?
I think it would.
Well, I mean, it'll work on a 16-year-old boy, but can I... What am I trying to? My wife right now is going, I can hear you. You know, like, she's in Austin now going, will you stop talking? But yeah, so I auditioned thinking I was going to get like the who's the one?
Dot Pixies.
Yes.
I thought you were going to get Dot Pixies.
That's the one I thought I was going to get. Yeah, and they're like, no, we're going to play this other guy. And it's like, Gunter? Is it like you talking about the penguin from Adventure Time? I was like, because it's so awesome, you know? But he's like, no, it's the Hershey Kiss. Oh, that guy. Okay, sure, that's great. And I loved it because he has one of the best final lines for me, which I can't say because, on the broadcast, he says, oh no. On the DVD, he says something else.
Does he curse?
Yes, he does.
Does it start with an S?
Yes, it does.
I remember that.
Yes. And it's great. I almost wish that I could have even taken it further and say, have his last line be, hey guys, watch this, you know?
Is that when he dies?
Yes.
Oh, snap.
But then I really wanted to be Annie. In the end, that was the role I wanted.
Yeah. Thank you, Annie. Yeah. That role also gets bigger. Oh, come on!
God. So, let's see. I always try to, I know we always open up the floor to questions, but always before any panel that I do, I try to go, okay, what can we give you guys that you don't have to drag out of us? That's why I kind of start with this, going, okay, well, what did I think? Do we want to talk plot? Do we want to talk actual recording? I mean, the great thing about Attack on Titan Junior High is Jessica and I got to record at our house.
Yeah.
Because we've built a studio each, and well, hers is way cooler than mine.
Yeah,
mine's cool. Just a closet with all my clothes in it. And
every time he comes out, he's gay.
Yes. So just, and I'm gonna just put this as a side note. See, y'all are all so young. Have any of you watched Mystery Science Theater 3000? Okay, do you know who Mary Jo Peel is? She was Pearl Forrester. Anyone? No? Okay, well, she's a friend of mine, because she lived in Austin for a while. And the best thing is she needed to record something, so she came over to my house and went into my closet, and of course my wife's bras are hanging on the thing, and I always remember her walking into there going, I'm gonna be a star, and she closed the door. Total side note, has nothing to do with this.
Did she come out of the closet wearing some of EK's bras?
Yes.
Because I've done that too.
On her head.
On her head.
So.
Like, your voices and everything. What do you do to, like, warm up for your characters?
warm up for our characters, like anime voice roles?
She's like, what do you do to warm up?
Well, I don't. So I feel like I'm a bad influence when I answer this question. I do not. Well, if I'm sick and I sound like I've been at an all night. Oh, I gotta be PG-13. All-night rave thing. I suck down this pecan kawaii, which is this amazing Chinese herb.
Minjong paper kol.
That's actually what it is.
Yeah,
okay, I'm not being racist.
I know. It's like black sludge. I took that too far. Like always, it's if I'm in like vocal disarray, Destiny, vocal disarray, Destiny. That'd be a great name for a girl band.
No, her name should be Destiny, and the first album is Vocal Disarray.
Yeah, girl, we can work on that together. We'll drop that together. Okay, anyway, so I will suck down the Chinese black sludge, and I will copious cough drops and everything. But that's not. I mean, that's like vocal like care and rest. As far as like warm ups. I don't do anything. I like to kind of go in and be just spontaneous. Lots of times when I go to the studio, I have no idea what I've been hired for. I just know that they're like, we need you for 6 hours or we need you for 2 hours. I'm like, cool. And I get there and I'm like, what's this? And I just jump in and I go for it, so.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah, in fact, I'm pretty much the same. For many years, I would drive between Houston and Dallas. And that gave me plenty of time to warm up because I would, I have seen you warm up a few times, and lately it seems to be all you're singing is Adele's Hello.
I hate that song.
She hates it, and yet she sings it.
No, I don't.
All the time.
I do not.
Yes, you do.
WTF. I do not sing that song. Shut up.
Okay.
See,
that wasn't me. That wasn't me.
Just saying. But I actually try to do vocal rest before I get going, because I have a tendency that if I talk too much, I think I have vocal notes because I got a little bit of buzz in the part of in there, and the longer I talk, the more it comes out. Which a lot of people like, but I mean, for me, I'm like, no, I want clear and clarity of my voice, not more of this going on here. So, I just try to save it and then find out what they want. Now, the interesting thing about recording is that if you're going in to record, whatever your voice is at the moment you start recording, you need to keep it that way for other sessions and remember what it sounds like. Because otherwise, you know, one time you're like, hey, how's it going? And the next, hey, all right, here we are, Hanji. We're gonna go do some science here today. Like, wait, those were two different recordings, weren't they?
And they'll turn you away. Like, I don't know if you got, but like, you go in with a cold or something. Like, if I had to record right now, they'd be like, let's take a few days to get your voice back because it has to match what you've already done.
Yeah, it would sound crazy if in, you know, one scene you were one voice and the next scene you're completely different. That would be like, okay, well, we're gonna have to write that into the character.
Of course, my wife says that when I have, you know, stressed vocal cords, I have the sexy grandpa voice.
We don't want to hear about what you and Ethan do when you're 19.
Grandpa. Yes.
I don't want to hear about your fetishes, your sexy grandpas with
hey,
your wife.
Hey, check it out. There's your sexy grandpa.
Hey, girls.
Okay, I'm sufficiently creeped the F out. David, what about you?
I do the vocal rest thing too, because I have the same issue that when I speak for too long, I get a little bit of raspiness going on, or it just sounds more pinched. I tend to play characters. I have a vocal range, my natural speaking voice, that is somewhere in the middle between, you know, the higher range of voice actors and the lower, gruffier voice actor ranges. But I get asked to do, I either get asked to do one that's really similar to my voice, or a bit higher, a bit younger, or really laying on my chords and doing, you know, like Briario's is really deep down laying on my chords the whole time. So I have to, it depends. Like if I'm doing something that's a lot deeper, I don't warm up at all on purpose. I just vocal rest, because then I can sort of sit down there lower and maintain that for longer. If it is something where I'm playing someone in high school or someone younger, I'll do a little bit of warm up to get that gruff or the natural sort of gruff out of there so that I have more flexibility when I'm in the booth. Because as I talk, I tend to get deeper, my voice gets deeper and deeper. So warming up for me is it depends on the session, but yeah, that's pretty much what I do.
My name is Daniel.
Hi, Daniel.
I want to know if you've started recording for the second season, and if so, what do you
it's
think
It's not out
you?
Yet.
Oh.
Oh my God, I jumped on you. I'm so sorry. I'm so defensive. It's not out yet! I'm sorry.
She's mad about it. Go ahead, what's the rest of your question?
Well, it kind of depended on the answer for the first question.
No, we haven't.
Yeah, we've heard all kinds of different things. The last time I was up in Dallas recording Titan Babies, it was Mike said that he had heard all kinds of different things, like that he had heard we might start somewhere in the spring or April, and then I heard 2017, who knows? So yeah, nobody knows.
I was just asking because the second season's about to come out.
In Japan?
In Japan.
Well, right. So like the last time I was in Dallas with Muppet Babies, Attack on Titan Muppet Babies, he had said the same thing, that the second season, the rumor was that it was coming out this spring, so there hadn't been an official release yet. There's like a trailer for season two, but that's not really an official trailer for season two. There's also a movie coming out, which has some different scenes in it. So, you know, we don't really know the dates yet of all that stuff.
I mean, I know we've recorded, I've recorded my part for the movie.
Yeah, I did too.
The anime movie. It's kind of a recap. It's basically a recap.
Right.
There's some new scenes in there, though.
Yeah, and then so the difference between the way we've always recorded for shows, a lot of times they put like 4 to 5 episodes together, and then we record all of those at once, and then they get released. With the Muppet Babies one, we were working on every week, recording for every week and getting it released at the same time. There is word that we will continue doing that with the series. Well, I mean, I don't know if I'm going to be in it, but I know that's I might be another guy. Wow, you sound just like Gunter. Shut up.
Shut up, I'm not him.
Yeah. No, I'm not. I'm someone else. Yeah. So it might be that the season might be coming up quickly, but which will mean that we will be working hard. It's not like we've got a month's notice. It's pretty much that once it gets recorded, once we do our recording, like they'll say, we gotta have it in by Monday. Then they're gonna release that episode on Thursday or Friday. It's very fast turnaround.
All right, who's next?
But we're all looking forward to season two. Right here in the front row, this lady.
Hello.
Hi.
Hello.
What's your name?
I'm Julia.
Hi, Julia.
Okay, so for each of you, what is your most favorite type of character to play? Do you like playing the comic relief, or do you like playing like a protagonist, a villain? What is your favorite kind of character to play?
For me, I love how I don't have a choice. I love how I just take my cue. What's so funny is the last question went Jessica, and then you took the thing, but it was Pavlovian for me. I was like, oh, I must be next. Oh. Oh, no, I'm not. And I don't question it. I just go with it. I'm like, yeah. I don't know if I can fit my character. I mean, they definitely do have some of those archetypal things that you just mentioned. I don't know if I can say one of those or the other. I like more complex characters. I like anti-heroes, actually, like somebody who should be, you know, who should in our minds maybe step up and be a leader, but for whatever reason, whatever they've got going on, however they feel, whatever has affected them to this point in the story, they don't, and maybe they overcome it, you know. That's my favorite kind of character to play. Other than that, you know, straight kind of hero characters are cool, but again, somebody that's got some other secret or something going on, that's the most fun to me.
Yeah, the good thing, I've got to play quite a few anti-heroes, and those are great because they get to be complex. Because the straight-up heroes, most of the time, seem to be the host of the show, and then everybody else gets to do the awesome stuff, right? And I mean, of course, being the villain's even better because that guy doesn't care. Like, he's like, I don't care where you like me or not, and so that makes him interesting, right? And then besides that, any kind of extreme range for humor, I love that too. That's always fun.
Oh yeah.
I'm so jealous of David Wald, who played Katse in Gatchaman Crowds. Have you guys seen Gatchaman Crowds?
Oh yeah.
What a dream role. First of all, David Wald's really talented. He's in Attack on Titan, I forget.
Hannes, I think.
Is it Hans?
Hannes? Is that how you say it?
Yeah.
Hans?
I don't know, him.
H-A-N-N-E-S.
He's a wuss.
Isn't he the one that at the first episode, but doesn't he save Aaron and Mikasa from in that first episode when Aaron's
kind
mom
of,
dies?
Kind of, but then the mom dies, and doesn't he bolt?
Yeah. Well, yeah, but he feels guilty. Yeah, yeah.
Whatever, he feels guilty.
Yeah, come on, man.
Anyway, so dream role, David Wald, and he plays Katse in Gatchaman Crowds, and his vocal range is just, I mean, all over the place, British accent, non-British accent. So I like playing those kinds of characters, which I've never really had the chance to play, just to really be able to like stretch your acting chops. But I like the zany characters. I like the Excel Sagas and the Hanjis and the Hajime. She's the lead in Gatchaman Crowds. But I really like the crazy characters, not because they're crazy, but because I like to find the levels in which they're not crazy so that it's not boring. Like with the Excel Saga, she's up here the whole time. And I wish I would have had the chance to be able to give a little bit more of range with her so it didn't get monotonous. Monotonous.
That's right.
Monotonous.
We didn't even hear that. You should have faked it, man. We all thought you said it right.
Monotonous. I said now I can't say the real word.
Monotonous.
God, monomena. Monotonous. Monotonous. And that was not monotonous, thank you. So like with Hanji, I really like being able to find those different levels with her, so she's just not all psycho all the time, because she's not psycho. She's a little off, but she ain't psycho. And so I really like being able to play the comedic relief and to find those ranges within those characters. So yeah, that's my favorite. Thank you. Yeah. Question? There's someone in the back.
Go deep. Go deep.
That blonde girl's had her
We're
hand
going
up for a while.
Deep.
Wow, that's a bit racy. You and your 16-year-old boys.
Hi. So we record a podcast called Watching You Watch Attack on Titan, and we just talk about Attack on Titan and like how I feel about it, and it's a lot of fun. But one of the things we talked about on an episode was like, who would win in a scream-off between Hanji and Armin? And
wait, who would win in a what-off?
A scream-off.
Yeah.
Hanji and Armin.
So, like, the overall question I have is, like, A, how did you find the perfect screams for any of your characters? Because there's a lot of screaming in the show. And then, what was that like in the sound booth?
Oh, yeah. There is a lot of screaming. And it's kind of like what I was just saying, like, if just talking about me and Hanji, like, we're the same person, that's not creepy at all, Jessica. Wow. But trying to find screams that just aren't annoying, because I think with characters like Hanji, it's easy to be annoying, because when she goes nuts, she goes nuts. Wah! But you know, finding those times where those screams can be different and varied. That's the word I'm looking for. Varied. Varied. That's the word I was trying to find.
I'm trying to find a word. We'll call it varied.
Think you'll call it varied. Okay. Anyway. But it hurts. I mean, it's painful, right? Screaming all the time, which is why you go, why you suck that down like there's no tomorrow. I'm nuts right now. I think I need some food. But yeah, I don't remember what I was saying. It's your turn.
Well, the way I find the difference between Armin and Hanji's screams, I didn't know
what,
that they
what
screamed.
What is that?
What?
Armin does nothing but scream.
Thought was, I thought that Armin would probably win.
Well,
it's not a competition, but if it had to be.
World.
But I mean, doesn't Armin do like...
Armin screams all the time.
So then there we go.
I think Armin wins.
Hanji has her selected moments when she screams. Like, you mess with her science experiments, there's going to be some screaming, right?
Right.
But Armin's just like, I'm really hungry! Why are you screaming?
You don't have to scream,
dude. You have a bowl cut. Stop it.
Aaron, you know, Aaron gets up to go to the bathroom, and Armin's like, Aaron, no! What are you doing?
Aaron, no! So just so, I have a bowl cut.
Just so I can be sure, Armin and Annie, those are the ones that look alike, right?
Josh would be so
happy. They both have amazing hair.
Yeah, but they, remember when we were watching it, I was always like, wait, now is that, which one is that? Who's, yeah. And Jesse was like, Brett. God, I was like, I'm sorry, they look alike. Oh, that's a guy? Okay, I didn't know.
I thought Armin was a girl when I first started watching the series. I thought Armin was a very pretty girl.
And Armin is voiced by a girl in the,
yes,
in the
so
Japanese.
Yes, so then okay.
Yeah.
But he doesn't look like Annie. What is wrong with you?
Okay. I'm a racist. That's the problem.
I think Josh Greeley would be really happy that we're sitting here without him screaming, Aaron, Aaron, no!
We do that all the time anyway.
I love in 18 plus panels, whenever someone says something really foul, Josh will pause and then I'll go, Aaron, no! It's amazing.
Josh has a great story about his first recording session. He had like been up too late the night before, and I don't know what other activities they've participated in, but like he had to warm up for an hour before and down Gatorade, and that was his first session to do those screams in that voice. But my character doesn't scream, at least in the first season. I don't know
Does your character do any?
Yes, my character's really. What were you gonna say?
Well, I'm just thinking, we look at your character so much, but there's not a voice yet, right? Well, there's for one of them.
God!
Have we all seen the show?
It's true.
No,
my character's...
The other one, there's no voice yet, right?
No, there's voice. Yeah, he's got two episodes where he speaks. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
We're not talking about the same thing.
Yeah, we are. Attack on Titan, the regular series, right?
Yes.
But he doesn't speak a lot. I mean, no, okay. It's an honest mistake. Honest mistake. No, really, seriously. He has like...
Sidebar.
I play Berthold Hoover. That's what we're talking about. Oh, I see what you're saying.
God, thank you.
You're saying we're not talking about that same thing.
Yes.
Sure.
Your mother.
Yeah, so my mom and dad don't bite. I know, that's awesome.
I need to watch the show more.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't have really anything to say about screams. My guy barely talks. But I do have this idea to go back and do you wouldn't call it a fan dub, but to dub... Because you see Berthold in the background so much through that first season, and you see, you know, and he'll just be there with his like sort of anxious eyes or shy eyes or I'm gonna stay out of this or whatever. And I want to do a dub of what he's thinking during all these
things. Like bubbles.
I want to do it so bad. Yeah.
Like bubbles.
Yeah, like bubbles. Weird. Yeah, yeah. And just you know, try to edit everyone else's stuff around that. I just think it would be so much fun.
That'd be fantastic.
So anyway.
And then they'd have to do a frozen scene and zoom in to where he's, and then you just see his thoughts and then they come back to the scene.
Yes! That's even better.
Does he have more, and I'm not trying to be like snarky,
no,
but does he have more lines in Attack on Titan Junior High? Does he talk a little bit more?
A little bit more, and he's got a dedicated episode. The one that was just broadcast, I don't know, I think it was episode 10, 9 or 10. It's a storyline with him and Annie, so some cool stuff.
Awesome.
Yeah. It's
you know what's kind of funny about this?
What?
Is I play the giant Titan in Attack on Titan Junior High.
You do?
Yeah.
Oh my God, spoilers. I didn't know that. I thought you did.
No, it's what? That scene.
Oh, the
scene
masks.
Where yeah.
Has 10 come out yet?
Oh.
How? What? Never mind, we're kidding. You guys, whatever.
I'm sorry.
No, 10 would have come out. 10 would have come out.
I think 10 yeah. came out last week.
I have
week.
A Funimation app if you want to check.
It's not.
I think 11 is this week and 12 is the following week. I think 10 came out.
It was just fun being yelled at as I was chasing people around, and then as I was being chased around in that episode, and so we made sure to record that bit. So that's not.
Who has a question? I want someone in the back.
Okay, so.
What's your name?
My name is Rain, or Sora.
Hi, Rain.
Hi.
Okay, so I have two questions. One is, how was it doing Attack on Titan Junior High, and then what was the difference from that, from the original Attack on Titan?
I'll take this one.
I got to talk.
Well, for me, experiential, I mean, obviously this is a sillier show. You know, yeah. Junior High is a sillier show. And, you know, like we did call it Attack on Titan Babies. So even the director called it that. It was a faster recording session. And I got to do it all from my house. So that was pretty darn cool.
Because did you Skype with Mike when you were doing it, or you just right?
Well, horrible lag with Skype. Yeah, so we would get the video and the scripts, and Brett would always help me with this.
I've created a process.
Yeah, it's amazing.
I've got a process now because I do IT work outside of this, and I've become very good at documenting processes, which sounds just so incredibly boring.
Yeah.
But it's exciting once you figure something out and go, we can all do it this way. This is fantastic. And so that's what I did. I applied that to this and said, okay, I don't use Pro Tools. Like, everybody uses Pro Tools in the industry. And I'm like, I'm not spending that kind of money on stuff that, no, thanks. I've got Adobe Audition. I've got Adobe Premiere. I can do all the same things that you guys can do. And they're like, all right, smart guy, here's all the stuff. Let's see if you can set it up. And that's exactly what I did. I went through and said, okay, we're going to drop the episode in. We're going to go through the script mark where
that's
it is.
That's so cool that you got
I'm going to add in three lines, so then that way we can just record one take, go back, now go to the second take, now go to the third take. Now we edit it through, process it, send it out, and it cut down the recording time. Now the downside of that is, yeah, we can get the guy to come, we can get the director to Skype in, but there is one a lag, so he can't really go, you didn't match.
Yeah,
he can't do that.
Off.
But he can say, I don't like the way you did that.
Right, just from a direction perspective.
Right. And so then once we get it done, we just edit it down to the things, we name it to the dialogue line, and then we compress the whole thing and send it back to him. Go, here you go. And that seems to work really well. And then, this is kind of pretty technical, but the amazing part was just trying to get the sound engineer to tell me exactly how he wants this produced. So, you know, you have different bit rates and hertz that you're supposed to do it in, right? And the director, Mike doesn't know, because I asked him, how do you want to do it? He goes, I don't know how to do any of that stuff. And I was like, oh, I thought you were supposed to know. And so I talked to the engineer, and he goes, 4,800 kilohertz at 24 bits. Make sure you put a filter through it at 100 hertz. I know all of that is just boring, but this is part of what we do. It's not just acting, right? And then once we got it through, I sent it to him and said, now, is this as good as what's in the studio? And he goes, very, very close. Which is good enough.
Right, right.
Because if you guys listen to the thing and you hear my voice, you're going to know that's in my closet right there.
His wife's bra.
That's so cool.
Yes, yeah. With my wife's bra hitting me in the face.
Right.
Just like, oh, I'm in heaven. So,
David, what about you?
Yeah, Attack on Titan Junior High was a ton of fun just because I don't always get to do more high cartoon, high character stuff like that. And I thought it was fun too just to get to see what those characters might be like at that time in their life versus, you know, where we first met them. So yeah, it was a ton of fun. You know, the episode that I got to do more in was him trying to, I hope this, does anybody care if I talk about episode 9? It's already been out, but he's trying to ask Annie out, you know, and Bertolt is trying to ask Annie out, and he's shy and nervous and he can't do it, and so it was a ton of fun to do Titan Babies. So different, so very different.
Yeah, like acting wise, with Hanji, you know, she goes a little ballistic, right, in that regular TV series, but in Attack on Titan Junior High, she goes really ballistic. So I got to actually just max out, like, wah! Like episode 11, which I think is this coming Wednesday. So you know how in the TV series she's like stabbing them in the eyes, like that's part of her experiments, like to see if they experience pain. So that's not what she does in junior high. I'm not gonna tell you, you have to watch. But it's really funny what she does, and it's really strange. And I do things like, and really like went just absolutely nuts. So I was so glad that I got to just really go crazy with her, because I had to kind of rein it in a little bit for the TV series. Who's up?
Hello.
Hi.
What is your name?
Hi, Joel.
That's Joel.
It's working.
Yes.
Joel. All right, what's the question?
Okay.
Do you think any of the characters have autism, or what should be closest to, like, beyond the autism spectrum?
The characters from Attack on Titan?
Yeah.
I don't know.
She's got to be on the scale.
I'm cuspy.
Yeah.
But seriously, answering your question, my sweet dear, I don't get that from any of them. It's highly likely. They're military, and it's sort of cultish, right? I don't know if they've been allowed to be really socially integrated. Where am I going with this?
I'd say that that Hanji, though, she's very focused.
I wouldn't say she's autistic.
Well, no, but she's on the spectrum.
I thought you were talking about me when you were pointing to me.
No!
I was like, I'm not really that. There's nothing wrong with autism anyway.
No, you got a whole different deal going on.
I really am different. I don't think Hanji's on the spectrum. I think she's a little off, but I don't think just because you're off, you're on the spectrum of autism. I think she's just in her own little world. So that's my opinion.
Interesting.
Yeah, I don't think... I don't get that from any of the characters, but, you know, who knows? Maybe. Not that I get. That's all. That's my answer.
It's good.
Cool.
Right, you're done.
My name is Ezio Auditore.
You kind of look like Captain Hook in Once Upon a Time. Woo! You know what I'm saying?
He's got a little bit of a Hook thing going on. Woo! Is that what you're saying?
A little bit.
My question for you guys is... What are your thoughts on the live-action movie adaptations?
Okay, I haven't seen it. I've heard the rumors. I haven't seen it. What about you guys?
I wish I could dub it.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
So I can get paid.
I haven't seen it either, but I've heard the rumors as well as mixed thoughts.
I've seen people looking unhappily, so I'm thinking...
Why I haven't been in a hurry to see it is because they took away my favorite character, Levi. Yeah. And they put in some blonde one with a mustache or something, and they incorporated Levi's character and another character that they kicked out.
Yeah, I don't understand that.
I don't either. And
like,
they
where,
changed...
What is the...
I don't know, and they changed Mika's character. She's like a damsel in distress, and that is just cool.
Right.
But that's what I've heard.
We had a discussion about this at one of my first panel yesterday, actually, and just some of the all of the stuff that you said as well. I mean, I think the whole Mikasa thing is like, man, that. I mean, she's such a great character, and you don't get that for female characters a lot in anime. And then. Taking her to the damsel in distress kind of character is just, I don't know. I'm really curious to see it, but...
Yeah, I want
to
see it.
I think that we should have attended those meetings, that we were invited to them,
yeah.
And we should have been there and really fought for...
We have no pull.
But I wish. I mean, you think... I wonder how much things would be different if the actors... had any kind of say over any of, yes, we're gonna actually take what you say into consideration.
There'd be a lot of unicorns everywhere if I had any say.
That's right. We can do one more.
One more question.
Samantha.
Hi.
Hi. My question is, who's your favorite character other than your own?
Okay, no, I'm kidding. I really, really like Levi because I have a thing for short guys. I really, really like short guys.
She does.
I do. Her guy's my height, and I'm pretty short. I'm like 5'3". So I think he's fantastic and sexy and smart and kind of a mother effers. And I like that too, so he's kind of my favorite.
Hanji.
God, there's so many to choose from, I honestly, but I've been asked this question before, and I have to say that mine's a little off the beaten path, but
I like that one guy that's in the back of the crowd. He doesn't even say anything.
I like
stands
the first
next to your character.
I like the first guy that died. No, I'm just kidding. I like Dot Pixis. Is that how you say his name? Or
he's fantastic.
I like that guy.
His
I like
eyes.
That he's that they didn't go completely stereotypical with him either. As far as you see him and you think like, you know, commander, gruff guy, whatever. And I love that he's a little eclectic and a little bit like a risk taker and, you know, just not what you would, he makes choices that you wouldn't think he would make. So that's my favorite guy.
I just like the way he's drawn with those freaky eyes.
Yeah, yeah.
It's crazy.
Yeah, he's really interesting.
So I guess we're out of time.
I think so.
Oh, it's 3:55!
He said 5 minutes. We gotta let the other people come in so that
are we done?
Staying. That's why.
5 minutes.
Yes. Just like
face.
College okay. class.
You guys, thanks for being here.
Thank you guys for coming so much. Thank you.